seahorse.
I know. They're about 2 inches large. Kill 90% of the time that they try to catch some prey. Most fish of a similar size, they have about a 30 to 40% success rate. And there doesn't seem to be a marine predator with a better success rate. They hunt something called copepods. So they're tiny little crustaceans, which are usually excellent at escaping because they can swim more than 500 body lengths per second, right? That's the equivalent of me swimming at 2,700 kilometres per hour, as opposed to what I actually do, which is look like the Queen Mary coming slowly into port. And they also have some of the fastest reactions in nature. So dwarf seahorses, some of the slowest swimmers in the world, top speed about 5 foot an hour.
Is that up or down? Because in the aquarium, they're in a tube, aren't they?
Yeah, but they can do anything. Up, down, sideways, whatever. They're amazing.
They're just going to have Sandy doing that on a GIF.
Yeah.
Aren't
they? The key to their hunting success is their sort of horsey heads. And what it does, it allows them to sneak up on their prey. So copepods know that there's a predator because they sense the disturbance in the water. But the seahorse's head perfectly is formed to create no wake immediately above and in front of the nose. And they sort of sidle up. They're like ninjas. They sidle up to the copepod and it doesn't even notice they can be like a millimetre away. And then the head snaps up and at the same time they suck inwards and they swallow the creature. We can show you a video of this. Oh. It looks so casual. It's just casually going along and there's a copepod.
Oh,
gone.
What?
Yeah.
So you're saying that little thing can't see it? Because I think I would see a seahorse coming.
Yeah. It's coming up from behind. I think you might.
Yeah, even from behind, I'd be like, is that a seahorse?
Seahorse,
that's
yeah.
What I'm saying.
Seems unfair. Seems like someone should be behind with some coconuts going. Shut up! I'm hunting the time to chase this bug.
They have terrific eyesight, which also helps them. I'd like this. Their eyes move independently.
Of each other?
Of each other, ooh. Yeah. So one can look forwards and one can look backwards.
It's like my great auntie Joan.
She was one of the great hunters as well, wasn't she?
Oh, stories in our family.
An adult seahorse needs about 30 to 50 meals a day.
Is it they're eating the little things? Is that why?
Because it's too small, darling, frankly, isn't it? You know.
So why don't you eat something bigger?
I don't know what's wrong with them.
Because I think to be like the second most deadliest thing, it should expand a bit.
Yeah.
Because when you said the second most deadliest thing, I'm a little bit disappointed.
Are you?
I agree. Because what they've done is they've chosen to keep their stats up.
Yeah.
They're like a boxer that won't fight the big boxers, aren't they?
Exactly. Yeah.
No, they are just going for the little guy, I'm afraid.
Yeah, that's a bit.
But they are extraordinary swimmers. The trouble is that it takes a lot of effort. They have to beat that dorsal fin 30 to 70 times per second in order to propel themselves along. And if they're in a stormy sea or whatever, they can easily die of exhaustion.
The males have the babies, don't they?
They do. They're unique in that. Males are the ones that give birth. But what I like about them, Kelly, they are sickeningly romantic.
Are they?
Oh, once they've chosen a mate for the breeding season, they come together each morning and they perform the courtship dance, which apparently strengthens their bond, and then they travel around, look, with their tails entwined.
Little notes of poetry.
Yes. And then they change colour as they go. They can mimic their surroundings by changing their colour, but they also do it as part of the courtship dance. I think it's lovely. And then, as you said, the male gives birth to the young, up to 2,000 of them, and then the offspring... Look at the offspring.
Oh, you'd think they'd eat one of those in a heartbeat.
But they're left to fend for themselves. And then within a few hours, they're ready to mate again.
And then they just... No, you have their visit.
There's no child care.
It'd be great if humans did that, wouldn't it? You'd be like, there you go. No homeschooling of the seahorses. Yeah, yeah. You said they're very romantic just for the mating season, though. Because anyone could be romantic for the mating season, couldn't they? It's like when you've got to do years of mating.
One might be gripping incredibly hard against the other one's will.
Saying you're
like
not going away.
Situation.
That looks quite passive-aggressive, those two. They've had an argument.
The sea's slowest swimmer is also its deadliest predator. What's all legs and...